NHS. Me llamo Zach. Y estamos en la Palacio Real de Madrid.
In case you didn't catch that, that's Zach and I'm Marla, and we're at the Royal Palace in Madrid.
Yeah, this is a really cool place. But I hear there's some cool stuff going on at home, too.
Yeah, I heard there's a sailing team. I wonder what's up with that.
Yeah, me too. Guess what? We got a segment by Fran Johnson all about it.
I'm Elizabeth McKean, and I've been sailing for 3 years.
I'm Maddie Welch, and I've been sailing for 3 years.
Hi, I'm Emily, and I've been sailing since last year.
I'm Spencer Dobie, and I've been around boats all my life, but I've been competitively sailing with my dad since I was 7, and I joined the sailing team last year when I was a freshman.
The most exciting part is when you're going around marks, all these other boats are piling up next to you, and there are a whole bunch of rules, so they yell and protest at each other, and you have to make sure that you're doing everything right so that they can't yell at you too.
I really like being in the boat and getting to sail out in the beautiful area that we do, and just being really close to the water and the ocean is really fun.
My favorite part is going to all the regattas and getting to meet all the different people.
Sailing team, we sail FJs, and these right here are two FJs. This is called the bow of the boat. We have port and starboard, which are just right is starboard, port is left. And we have the stern, which is the back of the boat. This is called the mast and the boom, which holds up the mainsail. And then the jib sheet goes here, or the jib sail goes here.
It's a really good sport to join, and you really form people say it's about all sports, but you form a tight group of friends, and maybe it's a little bit different socially because you're sailing with another person in particular, and you get a lot of one-on-one time with just one other person, like soccer, or maybe other sports where you're more as a group.
So for sailing, we have to wear a lot of stuff to keep warm because the water is really cold. So we wear wetsuits and Under Armour underneath to stay warm, and shorts to protect our wetsuits, and a coat so that all the water will stay off of us while we're out there, and it'll break the wind and stuff. And a life jacket so we won't drown if we capsize.
Yeah, the environment is like always changing, so that makes it a lot different from indoor sports or even outdoor sports, because we never really know how our course is going to be or how tough the winds are going to be. So that makes it a challenge every time you go out.
Well, this coming weekend there's a regatta in Kitsap, and that is Saturday and Sunday.
Man, that was awesome.
Sí, muy interesante. I just wish we could sail right now here in Barcelona.
Yeah, me too, but I haven't seen many sailboats.
Yeah, you know what else I haven't seen a lot of?
What?
Robots.
Yeah, me neither, because the AHS robotics team isn't here making them right now.
Yeah, they're great. Well, it's a good thing Garrett Mannion knows a thing or two about robots.
Yeah.
So, he's got a segment here all about it.
Welcome to the 2013 First Robotics Competition, and this year's game, Ultimate Ascent. Ultimate Ascent is played on a 27 by 54 foot field. Alliances of three teams each operate their robots from behind alliance walls at the ends of the field. Four scoring goals are located in each alliance wall, located at three different heights. Each alliance wall also has feeder stations located at the ends of the wall. Two large pyramids occupy the middle of the field, about a third of the way from the alliance walls. Each pyramid has three rungs leading up to the top, which can be climbed by the robots. At the summit of the pyramid is an additional scoring goal. Ultimate Ascent is played with standard flying discs of three different colors. The objective is to score as many discs as possible in the goals at the far end of the field. The harder the goal is to hit, the more points it's worth. Discs can be scored by throwing or placing them into the goals. Robots can hold up to four discs at one time. After gathering discs, they can try to score from anywhere on the field. Human players enter discs onto the field by passing them through slots in the feeder stations. Near the end of the match, human players can throw discs onto the field and try to score. At the same time, robots drive to their pyramids and start to climb for bonus points. The higher they climb, the more points they will receive. Robots can climb up the sides or the corners of the pyramid, but they have to remain there as the game ends to collect their bonuses. Good luck! and we'll see you at the competitions.
Day of Silence is a nationally recognized day led by students to raise awareness of the bullying and silence faced by lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender youth in America's schools. The Day of Silence was started by a group of students at the University of Virginia in 1996. Since then, it's been nationally recognized and happens every year in many schools.
The Day of Silence is where when you participate, you're silent for the whole day to show how many people have been silenced due to the bullying that happened because they're gay, lesbian, bi, transgender, or whatever, something out of the ordinary to most people. People commit suicide because they're bullied for being bisexual, gay, transgender, lesbian. Silence is not only showing the people that are currently being bullied, but the people we've already lost.
Suicide's the ultimate silence. There's nothing that can bring them back.
We're asking you to take part in the Day of Silence to show that you're against bullying.
Next week, on Wednesday and Thursday, we will have a table by the front doors in the morning and to hand out placards, which are a little card that you will wear around your neck that says what Day of Silence is and why you chose to participate. So that way if anyone questions you or doesn't understand, you can show them and they can at least try to understand why you've decided to take part in this. Day of Silence takes place this year on April 19th, which is it's a half day, it's a Friday, but we're still hoping that we can get our school to participate in something that is this big and this important.
Don't be a bully. It's not cool.
LGBTQ. Stop bullying.
Wait, bullying?
Bullying.
Bullying. Oh yeah, because pushed over.
Yep.
Hey Marla, where are we?
Italy, duh.
Wrong. We're in Vatican City, smallest country in the world, the center of the Catholic Church, and the home of the Pope.
Well, tonight's our last night in Rome, and then we're going to spend the last couple of days of our trip in Capri and Pompeii.
Well, lucky for us, Eva Knutson's got a segment all about it.
Let's go get lunch.
Yeah.
Students embarked on a trip of a lifetime on March 27th. Our trip started in the country of Spain and ended in the country of Italy. Each city took people's breaths away. Madrid was our starting point and we traveled to many small places. Toledo had the best views and Zaragoza had the best shops. We then traveled to Barcelona. We went to the beach and traveled around and took a bike trip around downtown. With street dancers to capture the essence. And nighttime spoons with Francisco. Rome was our next stop and we saw the Trevi Fountain and made our wishes. Sorrento was an amazing place to be. We swam and played volleyball on a gorgeous day. This trip was truly unforgettable. We had different memories, but in the end, we made them together.
This truly has been a trip to remember.
Indeed, but it's not over yet.
We're hanging out in Capri right now.
The home of giant lemons.
And spending our last night in Rome and heading home tomorrow.
Sadly, HS, this is all the time we've got for you today. So from our rocks to yours, ciao from Italia.